818.
Go with 8-ish, son. Yo!
They dropped it over the weekend.
Over the weekend.
Over the weekend, on the day that everybody was looking for Nas.
That's terrible.
It's not necessarily terrible, it's just healthy competition. It's okay, you can do it when you got your own
space. That ain't no healthy competition, bro. That's like the
and listen, this is what y'all don't know about. This is what you gotta have title to be able to hear this one. Guess who played first? Guess who got it?
Focus. Yeah, it's real.
It's playing right there. You can listen. Good early evening to everybody, man. It's your boy Tommy B with the big homie Farmer, man. It's Monday, man.
Money making money, baby.
Money making money, man. What was your weekend? Bad. How was your weekend like, bro?
My weekend was a little laid back, yo. You know. I was a little, you know, under the weather for the weekend. Wasn't feeling all that good, so.
Everybody should listen. It's a really good song. It's good music. And oh, by the way, he dropped it. Why they out there on tour? To me, that's pretty huge, man. That's what happened to me on the weekend, man, along with a lot of great stuff, man. We definitely take our time to talk about that, man. But it's just feeling good in the city as usual. Big shout out to the university. Even got the university in the building today, man. Brandon Kraft is here. Good feeling, man, right here in Star City. So we're going to do our best to keep it on and slash popping. As
my dear, right?
Yeah. Try to let the people know who's up in here real quick. Give them a chance to get up in here over the weekend. Always got to send a big shout out to the ladies who got it going in, this morning. The ladies first, man, are definitely doing their thing. Big shout out to them. Stevie Ice Mills up in the building. My love bud doing their thing. Eric Kane. What's happening? I don't know if we can do our IT training like on live. I don't even know if we can do that. I don't think we can. Oh man, but it is a lot to talk about, man. A lot of stuff did happen over the weekend that we're gonna get on and popping. So we're gonna go ahead and go to a commercial real quick and be back to talk about it right here on Focus Radio. Keep it live.
Conceited, in partnership with UPL, presents our third annual Networking in the City, Grow Your Network to Grow Your Net Worth, a nonprofit event that will benefit Apple Ridge Farm and UBU Back to School Drive. Hosted by me, Vernice Bell, and my co-host is Justin Hash, Saturday, June 30th, 5 to 9 p.m. Music will be powered by the one and only DJ Kid. Dressed to impress, 21 and over, I welcome. Bring your business cards. We will have guest speakers and door prizes. At Century Plaza Park, 14 Church Avenue, Southeast Roanoke, Virginia, 24011. For more information, you can email us at networkingthecity@gmail.com or call us at 540-353-1770 or check us out on Facebook. The third annual Networking in the City social is not always what you know, sometimes it's who you know.
Gigs, son.
Really?
You get gigs from doing that.
You get gigs from DJ. What's up about that?
I just feel good, man. Cold, man. You know, I'm like, the reason why I'm so really excited about already, you know, I'm the music thing, we got paid honor to those who've been holding it down, doing it like they've been doing it. So that's why I do kind of shout Jay and Beyonce out there. But I'm so excited, man, that Bruno can really get behind one of his own, man. We really can get behind 808 Ray, man.
Yeah.
808 Ray is on two of nine of the tracks that's on their surprise release. Come from a fella right here from the Star City.
Plus, you got a couple on Nas' joint.
Come on, man. Well, he had the Nas album done joint, and I think that Nas should have put that on his album. Because I like the Nas album in school, but it's actually, I gotta be honest, I don't even really know much about the Nas album because of what happened with that old Jason. You know, I tried to listen to it, but I had to go back to the album.
Well, everybody know how you're gonna do it.
Well, I mean, you know, say what you want to about it.
Yeah, you're fans, you're a fan, a big fan of both other cars. So.
What are you actually saying right here? But yeah, man, we also.
That's true, though. I mean, ain't nothing wrong with that.
I mean, I believe, so
like,
I think.
You like the wife, you know, and you just tolerate the husband.
No, that's not true. I think what people miss out of is that for real. Like, I really feel like there are people who are out there kind of leading the way and spearheading the stuff that we keep talking about what we want to do. And we've got to get at this stage in life the difference between, that's why I've always said Money Making Monday. Since we got to get out of the difference of just being able to be okay with saying it could be so versus seeing the opportunity and getting out there and letting it be so. These are people who, you know, who have stories now that are glamorous, but you can trace back the footprint of where they came from, that it wasn't always like that. It took some real grind, some real dedication, and now, man, they are at the top. They are there at the top. And then now, to me, like I posted, I hear a lot of young men around, because that fellow, 808 Ray, was giving beats and doing beats for guys here, for artists here, who wasn't really even taking their craft all that serious. And so he was trying to feed them and stuff then. And he pushed forth to go forward. So I can't hear young men here in the city now who say that the only option is to go sell dope or to go get caught up. I can't hear that no more. Because it's obvious that you can do more. So shouts out to that man being a pioneer for that, man. And he's a humble, that's a humble young man. This is a guy who was here last year, just last year, you know, when the Nas album Done Thing was on the way. He was here donating blood at our blood drive. And thanked us for the opportunity to do it. And then that Sunday I went out there to his pop's church and he was serving up in the church. So I'm really, like, I gave a grand speech for him yesterday.
I mean, I was ready, yo. I read that and well put, yo, really well put, you know. But it's been like, you know, it's been a family thing.
Yeah.
You know, it's been a family thing. So that right there makes a really, really special blessing, bro. Not only did you achieve something that could possibly go off and be great, you know, your family, you can trace where your family helped you along the way to get to that. And it's always refreshing to see when a family get behind anyone in the family dream and it come alive. So, you know, hat off to the young man. Hope you keep doing great things.
So, yeah, about Sunday morning. But yeah, man, it's a lot of good stuff
That's my bar.
Yeah, man. Yeah. The city, man, I think really does now have some incentive. At least I know I do. I know to say now, if you in that orbit, if you are in that vibration, you can connect that stuff, man. And so it really, I'm really proud of that young man. Like for real, man, I'm really, to see that happen, bro, that's amazing. And so now I'm going to almost have to start getting some validity. I think some of these artists who have been working, some of these guys put some actual good work to his music. The actual guy who kind of opened the door for him, Wayne Rains Hancock, put a project to it that I would love to hear him coming out of Philly and Rains doing stuff for like our age group, because Rains our age group, but it still is hot down for the youngins too. So I'm excited to see where that young man is headed, but like I told people, I ain't even really rushing it because I love where this young man is at right now. I know what it's like. Like, I had a good vibe in Miami, but he's in a good vibe down in Miami. At 20, I think 23 or 24 years old. Enjoy that experience, bro. Enjoy that. I don't know why. I mean, it's a part of a talk show. Is that you would engage in the conversation?
What you said was true.
It wasn't enough for you to say. I don't know.
Just put ketchup on a perfectly good sandwich.
What was that? You don't put ketchup on a perfectly good sandwich? I don't understand. Oh, man.
Why would you do it?
You don't have to.
Why would you?
It don't make sense.
Sandwich either got mustard. I'm mad at
it. Speaking about sandwich, did you cook out or anything like this Father's Day weekend? What happened Father's Day weekend?
Yo, for real? And not because it was sports or anything on me, anything like that, for real, but
Children of the Roanoke Valley just can't wait for the fun at Apple Ridge Farms Summer Academic Camp, all at no cost to qualifying children in underserved areas. This is where Apple Ridge Farm needs you. It costs $800 to send one kid to camp for 3 weeks. Help sponsor a child's unforgettable summer with memories to last a lifetime. Join us as we transform the lives of our community's underserved children. Visit appleridge.org and click on the donate button today. Apple Ridge Farm, serving the community since 1978.
it's all in me. Yeah, I can be every woman with Bree and B. Fashions and accessories.
I am LaVon Sanders, and I am WooWee. WooWee stands for Women Helping to Encourage Women, Women's Empowerment. I created this group because I've seen for a long time how we as women treat each other, and I felt a platform was needed where we can have those conversations with one another. We should be able to support each other and be on each other's team. There tends to be a lot of jealousy amongst women, and I just think at the age we're at, it's time to let go of those issues. This is why I created WooWee, and I appreciate everyone's support. Let's continue to ride this journey together. Again, I am LaVon Sanders, a woman helping to encourage women.
We in there?
We back? Yeah, what you mean? Where we at now?
I mean, I'm just trying to make sure. Right here.
Right here.
Look, man, it is, I'm excited about like right now it really feels good that we have been able to put a platform here that is somewhat appealing. It's different being in the technology space. I like the fact that we have some young men who are behind the scenes, so I definitely want to give them a shout out. Definitely Raheem Key, man, he's been doing stuff for a good month now with our intern program. He's definitely taking it to another level with the production of this show. And now we had a young man step in today, Mr. BJ. And it just feels good, man, to now kind of see and hear these young minds and see the stuff that's going on with them. You know, just all the things that are attached. Seeing how Erica's Focus Fashion stuff is really, really getting another level of stuff, man. They're about to get on the road, bro. They're about to get on the road this summer.
We're going to walk the catway on the road.
Man,
I gotta get my walk back, yo. I can't go out like that.
I'm hearing beaches and stuff. Like, I'm hearing white beaches.
White sand?
I'm hearing sandy beaches and stuff. I'm hearing that type of stuff.
Mama, we going, mama.
So
mama, we going. Oh, we going, mama. Callie say she going too.
Oh, man. It does, you know, because for so long you hear people say that it's not possible, or it can't happen, or it won't, or we gotta do this, or it has to be done. But you know, I really take my hat off to like the movement, man. The movement at T-Boy, our last T-Boy, which we really want y'all to get involved with. Take Back Our Yard is something that is not about us. It's something where it's now those opportunities that haven't been there. Here's an option of where we're building a trust that's going to now be able to help out small businesses to get their startup stuff, get them the resources they need, West Pugs and Associates and other different resources we had to get your business started. Get you that 2 years, man. Everybody start when you come into business, man, have in your mind that you're going to need 2 years of patience before you really expecting to see a whole bunch of money coming off of that.
I mean, people just got to understand, yo, it's a grind.
It's a daily grind. Get it? It's a daily grind. Are we using another camera?
I'm gonna tell you right now, that's the same thing he asked me the other day. See, he be messing with people. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What?
What other shot at? I'm waiting on it.
Hey, man.
This is a different shot. I'm talking. It's supposed to be a different shot.
Oh, now you want it. He took his first off. So, Riley, I do got to say, you know, he took over Friday. It was a hot mess. We was looking for a commercial for about 2 minutes.
He did
awesome. He did awesome for the first time. But we were both looking for a commercial for about 2 minutes on air.
Yeah, we both was. That were both of us. He couldn't find a damn commercial. I ain't know where it was at.
Had no idea, man. Oh,
you
man, but
mail over, man. You got mail.
I got some mail. That's why I said I saw
turn
some.
It over,
huh?
You don't let nobody see the top of the mail. You turn it over.
It's
no.
Okay. It's okay, no. Fam. It's okay.
No. Privacy laws.
We are really live here in here today, man. CNN Gainesboro. that's the one good thing about, like I say, each weekend, seeing Jordan Bell here up in the room. The documentary is coming, man, to let us know the history. 100 years later, man, we're going to knock this thing out of the park, man. Really excited about the DSZ Insurance being down here again. We want to keep our minds on thinking about that, because, like, I'm looking right now, man, music does influence our young people, and I think that's another reason why we put so much energy in the radio station, because at least trying to be tied to the younger people that's coming up. So I think I was talking with some of the younger kids over at the Well, and a couple of them said their favorite artist was this XXX
Tentacion. I don't know that.
How you say his name, Ron? How you say, what's his name? XXX
Tentacion.
And I don't want to mess up that young man's name like that, or whatever he goes by. But breaking news says he was shot in Miami. Witness say he has no pulse. So, you know, it's like Snapchat users are reporting that chart-topping rapper XXXTentacion was shot and apparently lifeless after being robbed in Miami. Witness told TMZ he had no pulse. The rapper was reportedly shopping for motorcycles. So I don't know all the, you know, where it's going for, but just the mere fact that this stuff is now accessible to excited minds, and like to be able to now have a bridge, have some options, is what we're feeling good about. But in the same sense, in order for us to continue on, we're gonna have to dial in on that type of stuff, man. So we are asking for, if like we made this call out before, which brought young BJ down here, is that if you are a parent, you have a young person we've got a couple people who right now they're in college, or they finished up college, got to get their internship. We got some awesome opportunities out here and some excitable things in the technology space that can support these young minds to be able to do that thing right here in a vibrant downtown Roanoke City.
I like Roanoke City.
Uh-huh.
It's a city.
It is a city. DJ. What is he doing? Who is this guy today? I don't even know who this guy is today. I have no earthly idea. I have no idea who this guy is today. But we're going to go one more break, man, and we'll be right back, all right?
Hello, I am Zariah Bell. What happens when stories are left out of history? This summer, stories will be put in their proper place. A community of people who built institutions such as the Clayton Memorial Clinic, Borough Memorial Hospital, Harrison School, Addison School, and many more. We sustain streets such as Henry Street, Gainsborough Road, Patton Avenue, and Gilmer Avenue. Gainsborough Revisited will go into detail with interviews from the people who directly impacted the community of Gainsborough and Northeast. They will give the stories of how their families made an impact on the community and city. They will explain what once was and what happened to it. Churches, businesses, homes were destroyed. Land was taken for what would later be known as urban renewal. Who was responsible? What was taken? Why would this happen? Who benefited? And is it happening today? This documentary was the inspiration of Jordan Bell. Growing up in Roanoke, he wondered why the things his grandmother, aunt, and mother said was in Gainsborough aren't there now. So he started to research. Civil rights, education, law, business, medical, religion, and all have a special story in Roanoke. With the help of many, those stories will be told. Thank you.
Are back.
Are we?
I don't do it. I don't even do it. The thing is that people will blame and listen.
Don't make no damn sense.
And put
all
it,
the time.
And put it
it's
worse.
Always me.
But you put you really put it up. Hey man, it is Monday, man. But listen, basketball.
What?
We forgot to tell them though. It is 5 o'clock somewhere. We are aggressively
seeking to be responsible.
We're going with Sam today because Sam had a good time down here with us this weekend. We do love the fact that this space, the Daily Grind, we do open it up for you to be able to have events and things like that. We had a car party down here this weekend, played on some Big West, and oh, by the way, I ran to Boston. Oh, by the way, I ran to Boston. Just so I let everybody know that. Yeah, I ran to Boston. So
I ain't see it.
I ran to Boston and
I don't believe it. I ain't see it. I wasn't.
I mean, I got the paperwork around here somewhere. That's one thing. Speaking of paperwork, man, a lot of money making stuff around in the NBA to talk about it, man. I'm hearing deals being made and you know, just seeing who's going in that top five in the draft. What you thinking, man? How's it gonna play out?
You never know. I just, you know, I mean, you got two big guys that's coming out. And both of them, they versatile, but they big.
Mm-hmm.
And you know we're going away from the big man, so I don't know if this is a new age of where we're going to get a little bit more back to the big man.
Well, see, this is the thing about it. This is a different type of big man that's coming out and who I believe is going to be the number one pick, but it's a lot of speculation. And Marvin Bagley, yes, who played at Duke Blue Devils, that's a different type of big man. He's not the average center like the other guy out there. Where's he? Arizona? Where's he going?
Arizona, Drayton. Drayton, he going number one.
Bagley's going number one.
Drayton is going number one. Ain't even a problem. It's not even a question.
It's not even a question.
It's not even a question. He was born in Arizona, uh-huh. Went to high school in Arizona.
What they got to do with
it? Went to college in Arizona.
So let me tell you what.
The Phoenix Suns got the number one pick. It's a no-brainer. What's going to sell?
So this is what if that theory was true and being utilized through all of NBA, I would have been able to say the same thing for a young Winslow, who a couple years back was North Carolina bred, played at Duke, and now Charlotte needing that type of player passed on him to go get the boy from...
Who the owner of Charlotte?
Michael Jordan.
All right, then. No, we ain't going to do that now. We ain't going to judge that up. We know what that was. That was pure hate.
That's what it was?
Pure hate.
That's what it seemed like.
And my homeboy, as I say something about Michael Jordan, Mike Hancock comes in the building. I'm going to hear about this.
I mean, I don't understand how they didn't get Winslow. And now that you're saying this and your theory behind it, which I think Bagley is purely and truly the best player in the NBA, and Phoenix right now needs that.
Does the best player always go number one?
I know. Honestly. I'm talking about this time. You're not going
to
sway me.
I don't have to sway me with that. I like Bagley now. I'm a big fan. Don't get it twisted. I like Bagley. Yeah. But
he likes him. He himself said he's not even really, no disrespect to the rest of the teams. Bagley said that anybody who basically don't pick him as first, y'all tripping. Y'all ain't been watching me. But the story reads out of ESPN dropping the top five center riskier than ever before. This is Kevin Pelton's article. Said the top picks in the next week's NBA draft are going to look very different from the league's just concluded playoffs, and not just because, as usual, most of the teams with the best picks are those that miss out on the postseason. Starting with Arizona's DeAndre Ayton, expected to be taken number one overall by the Phoenix Suns. Many of this year's top prospects are centers. The latest mock draft by insider Jonathan Givony has either pure centers, Ayton, Muhammad, Bamba, Wilton Carter Jr., which I ain't think about him. Like, yeah, he coming out, yeah. Or forward centers, Marvin Bagley, Jaren Jackson, going within five of the first six picks. But that's what's being said out there, man. I don't know how I feel, especially after how basketball season ended this year. I'm only thinking about the Roanoke Rising Stars because I'm so mad about the NBA right now. That was the weakest way. There's no way you get swept, though, in that fashion, though. There's no way you get swept in that fashion.
You're talking about your boy.
Huh?
You're talking about
your boy. He's not my boy. That's why I don't even understand why you keep putting that on. I don't know why you keep doing it. Huh? You can go, bro. Go.
Yeah, play the video. Please play the video.
Him hitting no step back threes is not why we lost the game.
Shut up!
Anybody seen the video?
It don't make no sense.
Don't make none, but just how time it feels.
That's not how I feel. I'm not a LeBron fan like that.
He LeBron.
I'm not a LeBron fan like that. It's just,
yeah, you are.
That's not true. I just said that the man, you got to give him respect for what he's done with a team. Because I know what it feels
say
like.
Again.
That's ignorant. That's very ignorant right there, what you're doing. Man, but I still can't get over that, man. I don't know what to do with it. So I don't even know if I'm going to get excited about basketball over in that ranks until the season starts.
Nah, you gonna get excited July the 1st.
I'm not.
Okay.
I'm not. I'm not.
Okay.
I'm not.
I said all right.
I'm not. I'm waiting.
I said okay.
I'm waiting for. I am kind of waiting for.
Keep pounding.
Yeah, I am waiting for that to happen a little bit. I'm waiting to see what's gonna go down.
Somebody gonna punch y'all straight in the mouth.
I don't think so. See, what I'm trying to tell y'all this year is they had. Everybody was paying attention to McCaffrey last year. This is McCaffrey's breakout year. This is the year that you see why they went with McCaffrey like they did. Because what's going to happen, they went and got the receiver that's now going to allow Cam to start being in the pocket more. Cam don't need to run and stuff as much as he used to. He don't have to. He still needs to be able to have that weapon, but he don't need to rely on that no more. Cam can really throw the ball. Cam can really put balls in tight windows and stuff, now having receiver core that he got. That,
anybody out there in Facebook land see my face and understand.
But nobody care because you're going off of a Raiders team who has shown that they can't do nothing without a quarterback. Card falls and what happens to y'all? Who you at? 2 years in a row. So we can't even talk about Raiders. Raiders don't even really, you know, until y'all move to Vegas, it's no even news. It's no news over there. It's no news over there until y'all move to Vegas. And that's going to be the news. It ain't going to be talking about the team.
And y'all done what?
Say what?
And y'all done what?
We were. We could have won the Super Bowl.
You could have. Yeah, I'm just
we
checking.
Almost won
I'm
won
not
going to
do this with you. I'm not going to do this with
we
you.
We almost won the Super Bowl. If we went for that darn Von Miller, we would have won the Super Bowl. That darn Von Miller. But I think we're on our way there, man. I think we're going to definitely put it together here, man. Let's go to one more quick break, man. Talk about Apple Ridge Farm and come back and say goodbye to people, all right?
This summer vacation, find adventure at Apple Ridge Farm Academic Summer Camp. Exciting hands-on experiences for 6 to 16-year-olds with daily learning and outdoor fun. Kids love the hiking, climbing towers, zip lines, high and low ropes courses, swimming, and tennis. Moms like that their kids are learning programming, reading, music, and environmental education, and leadership skills. Free to qualifying youth with sliding scale fees also available. For more information, including free health screenings, visit appleridge.org or call Apple Ridge Farm, helping kids grow since 1978.
Incoming news. we're getting incoming news right there. I'm hearing something about a Space Force branch.
Man, I'm not playing with y'all.
I'm not playing with y'all. He's live on NBC talking right now. I told you we got to update the over. We got to modify. We got to get you some new software, man. Because this happened before. The Jetsons stuff that we watched as kids. It's here. We're like the Jetsons. It's here. We in that.
Hey, Judy was fly though.
Really?
What? Y'all lying if y'all say she wasn't.
Man, we gotta get up out of here. What you wanna say to the people before we get up out of here?
It don't cost you nothing to be nice like Judy Jetson.
Like Judy Jetson. Like Judy Jetson, man. That's what it's all about. Hey, listen, Big Daddy is going in back there. He is working it out.
He worked it out back then.
Man, y'all make sure y'all tune in to Focus Radio by downloading from your Google Play or iOS App Store to your phone. We our own app. We the only one around here. But really? You got to do it. What you doing about that? No, I was about to give it to him. I was giving him a joint. Give him the whole school of scrap. They're too young to know about it, though. Everybody here pretty much. Except
yeah, they'll look at us like we're like, crazy as hell.
Like, what is they doing? They don't even know about school of scrap. They came to run up. Forgot about that. Talk about that.
Came.
We're talking about concerts Friday. They came to run a guy that did. Scuba Scrap did their thing up on stage. But that's the essence of what we bring it back to the city, man. T-Boy is coming. Learn more about it by going to takebackouryard.org. This is how we're going to all do it. It's not like one person. We get to a place where everybody will be like, well, I ain't going there because it's theirs. Right? Man, this is something we say, look, it ain't nobody's, it's ours. Everybody come in, let's just get in here and do the thing, man. This close to downtown, we deserve. Excited about Adrian Crutchfield's coming. So, man, it's a lot of good energy down here. So, we're
there's
excited.
A lot going on.
Yeah,
there's
man.
A lot you're going on. Pablo.
Pablo?
Coming. Yeah. Who's for Pablo? The youngins, man. I'm for the youngins, man. Ain't no Pablo, like Pablo, man. Don't do that. I like told Pablo, you, you don't want no smoke time.
I didn't know you talking about Pablo. I was like, Pablo, I really
don't want no smoke, man. Come on, man. Do your closing for one of them youngins be banging on the door here in a minute, man. I ain't got time for that.
Oh, I ain't worried about that. We got good.
I know we got gorillas, but you stop it, man. Come on, man.
We downtown. We got the police. We got the
say your goodbyes.
I tried to, but it's all good, man. It's a real good time in the city. Of course, man, I always love to leave by saying that thing in society. It's not a dream, man. It's your purpose. Set your sights on your targets and hit them, because the only one can stop you is you. Once you truly start to believe that thing and walk in your act of faith, God will allow it to manifest. And I promise you, it's not something I heard. It's something we're living every day and so grateful for it. Being a broadcast live from the great city of Roanoke, Virginia, man, out to the world. Today, the Grind Show right on Focus Radio. Keep it locked and have a good day, y'all. Peace.
The Bradley Free Clinic provides free, compassionate, and high-quality medical, dental, pharmaceutical, and preventative health care services for Roanoke Valley residents who lack the resources necessary to maintain their health and productivity using volunteer health care professionals. Check them out on their website at bradleyfreeclinic.com.